I am very happy. Just now, our Honorable Minister has rightly mentioned the way urban population is increasing, future of urbanization. In that context, third BRICS conference we are having in Visakhapatnam. We are very happy for that. If you see the trends of urbanization, by 2050, more than 50% of population will be urban all over the world. Even some of the countries already crossed 70% also. That is the scenario. As our Honorable Minister rightly mentioned, already there are so many challenges. Whenever there is a migration, we are unable to plan simultaneously, especially in terms of housing, infrastructure, basic services, food security, health, education, decent jobs, and natural resource also is a big problem. Because of that, day by day, in urban area, there is a heavy pollution, and also if you see, we are creating more and more slums. This is the biggest challenge for all of us. It is a big challenge for sustainable urban development also. When there is a sustainable urban development, then only we can plan properly. Even there is no proper planning, there is no proper mobilization of finances. Even in development, we are doing haphazard. And also governance also, because of all these things, there is no time to govern. These are all the problems we are facing today. If friends, you are all aware, all of us wanted to create most livable cities. This is our main aim. For that, Government of India has initiated so many initiatives. One is Swachh Bharat. In Swachh Bharat, urbanization, our Honorable PM has given top priority. I am very happy, even on our Honorable Minister has created so many competitive areas for urban development. One is housing, one of the best policies they brought. They want to create housing for every citizen in urban areas. Naturally, housing is a sentimental issue and also security issue also. And at the same time, smart cities, they are able to create competition now. Either Amrit cities or smart cities, they are able to create competition. Because of this, there is a competition among all urban bodies. Even I am asking my minister, my secretary, why you are unable to compete with that competition. That competition is uniform all over the world. I am very happy for that. I really appreciate our Honorable Minister and also Government of India for creating this type of accountability and also focus. We are all India friends, you are all aware, in BRICS countries, India also is moving very fast now. Our Honorable Prime Minister, even he has promoted India, is having very good relations with so many countries. If you see now, for the last few years, India is growing very reasonable growth rate. Even last year, 7.5%. According to me, this is only the country in the world which is growing reasonably very well. We are having advantage. India will grow at the rate of double digit. For this, if you see, one is democracy. Second is biggest market. Third one is all demographic dividends is in favor of India. If you see the population, that is the biggest advantage India is having. In our state, we wanted to promote, our state is a new state. It is only 2 years, 4 months baby. We had a combined state earlier. From there, we are divided. There is no capital, but new state we are working. But we are having so many advantages, we are deriving all these things. we have created a vision. This be amongst the top three states in India by 2022. Be the best state in India with high happiness index by 2029. Be the most preferred destination by 2050. If I wanted to achieve this, naturally, I have to go for urbanization in a big way. You are all aware, in urban area, wherever there is beautiful cities, then most of the income is coming from that city. Even for combined Andhra Pradesh, I have developed Hyderabad in a big way. Earlier, we had two cities, Hyderabad, Secunderabad. Within 9 years' time, we added one more city, that is Cyberabad, for information technology. Now that city has become one of the most important knowledge economy. So, as a reality, for any urbanization, any economy, urban population is very, very important. Then only we can grow and also we can bring prosperity. For all these things, we have growing with a mission approach. We have created 7 missions, 5 grids, and also 5 campaign modes. We are going in a big way to achieve our goal. Here, if you see gas grid, I wanted to connect every home with gas so that there is a sustainability and also we can reduce pollution also. And also we want to give water for every home with the tap water. Even in municipalities we are working. Even power grid, all my municipalities as on today 100% connected, not only municipalities, state also we have connected. 24/7 quality power we are able to give. And also roads also we are concentrating in a big way in urban areas. Ultimately fiber grid, through fiber grid, I want to take fiber to every home. Generally, we want to take underground cable. It is costing huge money. To start with, I am taking through electrical poles. Every home is, we are providing power. Through electrical pole, I am taking one fiber grid. It is only less than 10% of original cost we can spend. We can connect every home. By 1 or 2 months' time, it is in advanced stage. I can provide 15 Mbps for every home. On demand base, I can provide gigabit capacity. And at the same time, if you see, if they pay 149 rupees, it is only less than $2. I can give 100 channels and also video conference, internet, and 3 telephones. I am confident this is the best in the world. Nowhere they are able to give this type of facility for connectivity. If you see here, this is very interesting for all urban bodies. Resources is one aspect. Leadership is another aspect. If all of us will provide good governance, you want to provide good governance, naturally, it all depends upon the leader. One strong leader with a vision, then all other things we can mobilize. That is where every municipal chief or corporation chief has to think over how best you can govern, how best you can mobilize and augment all resources. Even here, I wanted to, this is a very interesting place we are all here. This BRICS countries constitute nearly 53.4%. And also world GDP 23.1%. And also world trade 17%. This is where important people are all here. Now I wanted to place before you, this is very interesting now. We are all passing through 4th industrial revolution. 1st industrial revolution, we are all aware, that is from agriculture to mechanization. 2nd industrial revolution by innovating electricity. 3rd industrial revolution by moving information technology, by innovating internet and also information technology. Now, 4th industrial revolution is a deadly combination of technology and also Internet of Things. This is where municipalities and also all of you, there will be a tremendous advantage. One is, if you see here, street lights. I am using sensors in all street lights. In 110 urban bodies, we are having more than half a million LED bulbs. By end of this month, every bulb will be monitored from central control and command room. Even I can off, I can fix service standards, what time bulb was burnt, at what time they have replaced, all these things I can fix from central control room. As our Honorable Minister has rightly mentioned, in India, ours is the first state, 100% ODF by October 2nd, we are going to achieve it. It is 100% ODF. All 110 municipalities, we want to achieve that. And also, if you see here, waste to energy, we are going on all municipalities. Around 11 municipalities and corporations, we are going for waste to energy. Remaining all municipalities, we are going waste to compost. And also various ways of conversion also we are going. That means 100% we are able to manage solid waste. There is no doubt about it. We are going to manage solid waste. Even sewerage, we are thinking very seriously. In a time-bound program, we are going to do that also. Even building permissions. This is where you wanted to create a participatory from public, then naturally you have to provide all technologies and also confidence and also corrupt-free governance. That is also very important. For this first time in India, all building permissions, it is on online. You need not go to any municipal office or any town planning, anybody. If you can put all your certificates, it will be online with the real time, we will clear. That is how we are moving. It is in operation. It is doing wonders. We are very happy about it. And also, if you see here, I want to go next step. We want to have CCTV cameras in all states. We are all thinking CCTV cameras will work only for traffic or otherwise some more areas. I wanted to use these CCTV cameras for cleaning, auditing of cleanliness, and also rowdy sheeters or criminals movement, and also another thing, this is traffic and other areas. And also if you see public toilets, you can use technology in a big way. If you take that photo, even smartphone photo, you can have a machine reading. Either CCTV camera footage or otherwise machine learning, this toilets photos, you can put it to machine learning. It is giving exactly clarity. That is a very good average, bad, it will read. Real time, you can communicate. One experiment we are doing now, fiber. We are going to connect every home. Real time, we are going to do meter reading of power. Real time, you can do meter reading of water. So that water you are going to read, and also quality you are going to read, and also we are going to read power. No need to go to his residence and disturb him. All services you can play online. That is how we are thinking in a big way. Even welfare programs, we are using biometrics, either pensions for individual citizens, public distribution system, all these things we are using biometric. It is working very well. Now technology, you are all aware, CCTV cameras, smartphones, drones, biometrics, even ultimately robotics also are coming. Machine learning is coming. What I wanted to impress upon you all, these are all the technologies available for all of us. And at the same time, our aim is to go for smart cities. Smart city, we are all talking. I am also asking, what is the smart city concept? All of us are saying the concept is very simple, most livable. which is the most competitive city. That is where we are working. Ultimately, small changes will change totally. In Vijayawada, we have introduced happiness, Sunday happiness. People on Sunday, they are coming outside. They are spending time. They are enjoying half a day. They are relaxing. So I wanted to introduce physical literacy in a big way in all municipalities. We are all busy. We are all having problems. We are all stressed. For all these things, again, we have to introduce physical literacy. Either a cultural program, or playgrounds, or some other activity, people should do what all they want to do, where they are going to relax. Ultimately, this is where we are working. Ultimately, we have to attract good business. All municipalities should be pro-business. You have to do better business. Thereby, municipalities will get better income, and also they will get better employment also. Your duty is not only providing civic services. At the end of the day, you have to create employment for our people and also wealth for our society. Then only that will sustain. It is where I am requesting all of you, you think in that way. And also, you have to go for inclusive growth. In municipalities, if you see, one side, very big gap. Some people are having billions of dollars. Some people, they don't have livelihood, even hand-to-mouth, even better living standards. Not only better living standards, even filling stomach also is a big problem. So I am requesting you, keep it in mind, focus on inclusive growth rate, and also create employment, and also you have to continuously upgrade skills and also capacity building for the citizen. Then it will have tremendous impact. I am very happy, this BRICS conference. It is only sometimes all of us will sit together. Somebody is doing extraordinary work. We want to share with him. And or somebody has done good experiments, best practices, you will share with others. This is the best platform for that. With all ideas, I am very happy. Again, BRICS conference is going to be held in Goa next month. By that time, you must give some actionable best practices for making municipalities most livable. Those who are proactive, we all will adopt it. It is only overall benefit of the citizens who are all working. I am very happy you are all here. Evening, I am giving one dinner. All of you, I am requesting all of you to join my dinner. Visakhapatnam is a beautiful city. Even our Honorable Minister has studied from here only, from Andhra University, one of the most powerful university. From university, he spent some time in jail also, at that time emergency period. He is a very good fighter. From the beginning, he loves Visakhapatnam. But if all of you see, 2 days or 3 days, there is a business. If anybody wanted to stay here, you stay 1 or 2 days more. We are having best excellent places here. And also, our people are very docile, very positive. By this time, you should have noticed. This is a moderate climate. One side sea, another side beautiful hills, clean city. I can grade one of the best city in India. So I wish all of you best of luck, best of stay, and I wish all the best for all of you. Thank you. Thank you, Ananda.
మీ లడ్డూలు కన్నా మా బందర్ లడ్డూలు చాలా బాగుంటాయి కదా. మన కాకినాడ తాపేశ్వరం కాజాలు ఇంకా బాగుంటాయి కదా.
సుమారు 2,25,000 కోట్లు ప్రాజెక్టులు కొన్ని మంజూరైనవి, కొన్ని సూత్రప్రాయంగా అంగీకారం తెలిపారు, కొన్ని ప్రారంభమైనవి, కొన్ని పైప్ లైన్ లో ఉన్నాయి. ఇది వాస్తవమైన పరిస్థితి.